In this video, I just wanted to tell you an idea of how to create simple rotations when you are maybe teaching summer school or when you are in a crunch time and you just don't have this time to individualize just yet. However, I do want to put a disclaimer out there that this is not your end and be all if this is for a whole school year. This is just a starting point to keep rotations simple and not complicated. What we did for this particular classroom, this is a pre-K classroom intensive for very complex students with disabilities, and we decided to do 5 rotations. So we made a, you know, circle, we made a triangle, star, heart, and square. Now I decided to do different colors also, just in case the student didn't identify the shape, maybe they can match the color. So it would help me with those kids who are still learning their basic, you know, academics, their very pre-academic skills. However, if you have older kids, and again, you wanna do this in a crunch time, you can do numbers. So you can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or you can do A, B, C, D, E. Again, or you could do words, you know, like you can do reading, math, science, technology, you know, fine motor, independent skills. Keep it simple, or you could even have, again, if you have older kids, you can do the visuals. So this is just, all the students are having the same schedule. Our goal is not that. Our goal is that we want to individualize and meet each student's needs and differentiate on their level. So this is a starting point, but this is something you want to reassess and be able to put them at their level and keep pushing the student to the next expectation and challenge them, okay? So let me again just show you. We created everything ahead of time, laminated, cut out, Velcro, and then we created a strip for every student, and this is going to be their check-in board, okay? So again, very simple. I wanted to keep you some ideas. So now I'm gonna just show you, and I need you to be a little bit visual with me, but I wanna show you. Let's think of this white square as your classroom setup. The way we did this particular rotation is very simple. It is that we are going to start doing the rotations clockwise. So think of each little baggie as a center, okay? So students are going to start maybe some here, other here, then here, then here, then here. They may all start at different because we wanted to create, you know, different groups. We don't want to lump all these kids in one area. So we did spread them out so the adults could zone them better as well. But what we did want to keep is the rotation to continue clockwise. So the kids that are here, when it's time to check their schedule, they're going to come here. The kids that are here are gonna go here. The kids that are here will go here. So if you notice, we're always going to rotate the same direction. This is going to help you and the zoning adults to keep an order, knowing that the same group of kids are all going to go in one format. So if you have enough space, I would always leave one center empty. So if you have too much of a chaos when it's time to transition, maybe the empty, okay, you want to start with this group to transition, then this group, so you can move them slowly. Or if you're able to check the schedule for everyone at the same time, then when it's time that alarm rings and you tell them, okay guys, it's time to check your schedule, they all get up, go to their check-in boards, right, with their new schedule, and they all go sit. This is a simple way. And I know that, you know, like I said, this is a starting point, but I wanted to show you guys this style because it's something simple you guys can do. But again, we're reiterating that it is incredibly important to implement schedules. And as you start getting to know the kids, you can definitely, again, differentiate and meet your students' needs, challenge them to the next level of schedules. So we would start with this, maybe we would do maybe one symbol or a number, and then we would start moving into words, maybe, you know, again, full words, and you wanna keep pushing them to the next level. But if you're too overwhelmed, this is a very simple way to get started. I hope this video helps you and that you are able to utilize within your classroom.